Have you ever seen the movie Free Solo? In it, a guy climbs a 3,000-foot rock face called El Capitan. And the crazy thing is, he does it with no ropes. So he's climbing up this enormous cliff, and his feet are often pressed against the rock where it doesn't even look like there are footholds. And you're left wondering, like, what's even holding him up? The answer, of course, is friction. Very specifically, static friction. And static friction gives us the idea of something that's still, that doesn't move. And that's exactly what you want when you are rock climbing. You don't want to move because moving involves falling. Let's learn all about static friction in this lesson. Let's begin by reviewing our lesson objectives. First, you'll learn the definition of static friction. What is static friction? That's the question we'll answer. Then you'll learn the equation for static friction, so you can actually calculate it. And then third, you'll complete practice problems with static friction, so you get really good at using this idea. First, let's remind ourselves of what friction is in general. It's a force which resists motion. So take this box. It has a green force acting on it, something pushing it, say. And that would cause the box to move, except there's a friction force shown by the red arrow pushing against it. Now, another thing to remember about friction is that it's caused by matter in contact with the object. So, for example, if we zoom in on the contact area between the box and the surface it's on, we see all these jagged edges. And that's actually what gives rise to friction. That combined with gravity, the black arrow, when gravity presses those jagged surfaces into each other, it creates a resistive force that resists motion. What about static friction, though? Very specifically, when we talk about static friction, we're talking about the friction force acting on an object at rest, that is, one that's not moving at all. For example, here we have a guy pushing on a giant boulder. We all probably know that boulder is not going to move. And so the friction resisting that motion is static. Let's think about it in terms of the force arrows. Well, we have the guy pushing. So there's a force pushing forward on the boulder. Friction's going to oppose that force. It's going to be back in the opposite direction. And actually, that friction force backwards in the opposite direction will always cancel out the push force exactly for static friction because it's not moving. Okay, let's now look at the equation for static friction. Static friction is equal to this weird little u thing, which is the Greek letter mu, called the coefficient of static friction, times n, which is the normal force. Before we continue, let's zoom in on the normal force. We've talked about this earlier in our class, but let's remind ourselves what this normal force thing is. All right, so friction and weight are really highly related, and we'll think more carefully about how as we go on in this lesson. Remember that weight is the gravitational force down on this boulder. Don't worry, we're getting back to the normal force. You gotta wait for it. And that force, that weight, is equal to mass times acceleration. And because the rock is presumably on the surface of the Earth, it's equal to mass times the gravitational acceleration. Now, if there was no other force acting on it, that rock would just fall. The boulder would go straight through the ground, but the ground pushes back up, and that's what the normal force is. So remember that that normal force is the force pushing up from a surface. It's always perpendicular to a surface. And because it has to be equal and opposite to the weight, we know that the force of the weight is mg, so is the force of the normal. It's mass times gravity. So our normal force is mass times gravity. Okay, let's go back to our equation. The force of static friction is equal to mu, that's this weird u thing, it's a Greek letter, times the normal force. Well, that mu there is called the coefficient of static friction. And it's a measure of how high of a friction the surface interaction has. So, for example, let's say you have rubber on concrete. That's actually a pretty high surface friction interaction. And so you have a friction coefficient of 1. You have a coefficient of static friction of 1. Wood on wood is actually lower in friction, and so your coefficient of static friction there is 0.5. Ice on ice is very low friction. 0.02 is the coefficient of kinetic friction there. And the smaller this number, the smaller the friction force is going to be. Okay, so that's the coefficient of static friction. Now, one thing to keep in mind about static friction is that it depends on the applied force. What do I mean by that? Well, what I mean is that if you have a smaller push, so you push less hard, you get a smaller frictional force backwards. If you push harder, you have a really big push, then you have a stronger push backwards. And the reason is because we're always still when we're talking about static friction. And so the frictional force is always going to rise up to meet however hard we're pushing it, as long as the object's staying still. Which actually makes a slightly better equation, but a little more confusing, for static friction is that the force of static friction is less than or equal to mu times n. The very maximum static friction you could get is when they're equal. That's when you're pushing so hard that if you pushed even just a little bit harder, it would start moving. So remember that max static friction is achieved just before we start to move an object. Okay, now let's move on to solving a problem with static friction. Here we're told that an 80 kilogram wagon begins to roll only when a force of 210 newtons is applied. And we want to know what is the coefficient of static friction. Well, to solve this problem, we're going to need to grab our equation for static friction, which tells us that the friction force is equal to mu times n. What are the steps here? How are we going to eventually solve for the coefficient of static friction? Well, we have to do a few things. First, we have to find the force of friction, and then we have to find the normal force. And lastly, we'll plug those into our equation to solve for the coefficient of friction. Okay, how are we going to do each of those? We'll think through this situation really carefully so that we can solve each of these steps. Let's start with finding the force of friction. What we have to remember here is that the force of friction is equal to the force applied for static friction. So if I'm pulling on this wagon, the force of friction rises up and meets it. It has exactly the same magnitude. So what we can say then is that the force of friction is equal to the applied force. And we know the applied force, it's 210 newtons. And because this wagon is not moving, it's exactly equal to the friction force. So we can say the friction force is equal to 210 newtons. Okay, now on to step two, which remember is find the normal force. Well, here we have to recall that there's another equivalent force that's gonna help us solve this problem. And that is that the normal force is equal to the weight. So we know the weight of the wagon, and that means we can know the normal force. Remember, that's because the normal force is exactly equal and opposite to the force from our weight. Okay, so how do we solve for the normal force? Well, because it's equal to weight, we know that we can write that it's equal to mass times gravity, just like we saw earlier in our lesson. So the normal force is going to be equal to mass times gravity. But the thing is we know the mass of the wagon, it's 80 kilograms, and we know the gravitational acceleration of Earth. It's 9.8 meters per second squared. So we get 80 times 9.8, or 784 newtons. So now realize we have the force of friction and we have the normal force. And so we're all set now to find the coefficient of static friction. So the force of friction is equal to mu times n. Again, mu is that weird little u thing with the s subscript. It's just a Greek letter. If you called it u, that would be okay, but it's a mu. And now we're going to plug in the force of friction, which is 210 newtons, which is equal to mu, that's what we're trying to solve for, times our normal force, which is 784. So now algebraically, what are we going to do? Well, we have to divide both sides by 784. When we do that, we'll get 210 divided by 784 is equal to the coefficient of static friction. All right, well, when we divide those two numbers, we get 0.267 and a bunch of other decimal points. Now we have to round for significant figures. So when we look back at our original problem, we're given two numbers, 80.0 kilograms, that has three sig figs, and 210, that has two sig figs. So we're gonna take the lesser of those two, which is two sig figs, and we'll round to two sig figs, which is 0.27. That six got rounded up because our seven is greater than five. So that's the coefficient of static friction. Okay, now it is your turn. Here we have another problem. An empty shopping cart weighing just 12 kilograms begins to roll only when a force of 16.1 newtons is applied. What is the coefficient of static friction? A very similar problem to the previous one. So if you feel a little stuck, go ahead and rewind and rewatch that last problem one more time, and then pause here and try to solve this. In a second, I'll show you the full solution and you can check and see if you got the answer right. Okay, go ahead and give it a try. All right, I'll put the whole solution up all at once. So here, we followed the same three steps. We found the force of friction, which turns out to be 16.1 newtons, equal and opposite to the force applied to the cart. We found the normal force, which was equal and opposite to the weight of the cart, which turns out to be 117.6 newtons. We plugged those in to solve for the coefficient of static friction of 0.137. Let's sum up what we've learned. First, we learned the definition of static friction, where we saw that static friction is the friction force on an object at rest that's not moving. Then we learned the equation for static friction, which told us that the frictional force is equal to the coefficient of static friction times the normal force. And lastly, we completed several practice problems where we solved for that coefficient of static friction. Hey, hey.